Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you so much for joining us today for this very special presentation of Lanciano International Guitar Seminar. My name is Isabella Bonizio, and I'm the co-founder and co-artistic director of the event, together with Michael Newman and Laura Altman. I would like to ask our Zoom audience to keep the mic off, and you can keep your camera on. The event will be recorded, so you can choose if to show yourself in the camera or not. So I would like to start with thank you for hosting us to Collina Italiana and to Comites for sponsoring this event. And I would like Cristina to join me and Dario Corradini to join me here and say a few words.
So hi, everybody. Thank you for being here. I'm the program coordinator here at Collina Italiana. We are an Italian school. We teach Italian and we host events here, and we're very happy to also host this special event. And we really thank you, Lanciano International Guitar Seminar, for being here. And we really hope that we can keep doing this and maybe host more events in the future. Thank you.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everybody. As an amateur musician myself, I feel anxious only sitting here in front of the score. But joking aside, I don't want to take a lot of time from the music. What is Comites? First of all, Comites is, I'm going to give a very vague definition. It's sort of a town council for the Italians who live in this area, so the tri-state, New York, New Jersey, and Connecticut. And essentially, our aim is to support the Italian community that is here, and we are happy to sponsor this event. We think it's an important cultural event, and we would like to do more in terms of music and art and culture in general. And this is maybe one of the first that we do, so we're very happy that we finally could. And a special thanks go to Collina Italiana, in particular to Patrizia and Cristina, to work, that made this possible. Really, to find, finding a space in New York is not always trivial, and we're very happy to do this here, and enjoy.
Good evening, buonasera. We're very pleased to play some music today by Leo Brower, Cuban composer. And this is his free arrangement of a Beatles tune, The Fool on the Hill. Thank you.
Okay, what you just heard is a wonderful duo. Michael Newman and Laura Altman from the Newman and Altman guitar duo. And this is how the story started. When I moved to New York 12 years ago or more, I think, I met them in their wonderful event that is called New York Madness Guitar Seminar. And I was very pleased and very excited to see so many world-renowned faculty, wonderful player, friends. And my idea was to really bring to Italy the greatness of the American experience, most importantly, the absence of hierarchy. That is something that really I missed. But at the same time, I also wanted to share the beauty of Italy and Italian culture to Americans. So this is what I wanted to do, bridging Italian and New York to music. And I asked, with a little bit of ingenuity, to Michael and Laura to join my idea to create a similar event in Italy, in Lanciano, in the central Italy, which is the city where I was born, which is, renowned for an important festival that is mostly for orchestra. And I wanted to bring the guitar in the festival and to have an international event. So we started in 2013, and I will never imagine that we could arrive to the 11th edition, that is this year. And I would like, first of all, to thank Michael and Laura for trusting me and for building what we build and what we are going to see today in this 11th year of summer festival together. So Lanciano is a small city of Roman origins, where you can also see a lot of other curious architecture, in particular medieval and baroque. The event, Lanciano International Guitar Seminar, is hosted by Estate Musicale Frentana, which is this educational festival, mostly for orchestra instruments, that this year is at the 53rd edition, that saw so many important orchestra director and has his own orchestra that plays a wonderful, incredible repertoire that also grew in the last 12 years. Our event it lasts about 6 days, where we offer masterclasses, ensemble coaching, presentations by the faculty, and performances. This is one of our best elements. So the participants of Lanciano International Guitar Seminar performs in 4 or 5 concerts in very different venues, outdoor and indoor, in a medieval castle, in a Roman auditorium, in a medieval tower square, and in other places that you will see later. We have been hosting guest faculties supported mostly by Savarez strings and Augusti strings. And we had in the years top world renowned faculty like Gael Solal, Massimo Delle Cese, Vladislav Blaha, Elina Cecan, Castellani Andriaccio Duo, Frederick Brigante, Joao Luiz, Francisco Bernier, and Gianmarco Ciampa. Gianmarco actually started with being a student the second year, and then he came back as a faculty. So we also have a lot of success stories of our participants that we'll share even during the event. And masterclasses are classes, open classes. So the guest faculty and the faculty of the event offer their expertise and suggestions to the participants, and all the other participants can join and see. This is a learning experience. So not only they get suggestions for their own playing, but they also can listen the suggestion for other participants. Our faculties also offer some presentations about different topics like musicology or guitar technique, about their label. For example, we had Freddy Zigante offering a presentation about Mario Castelnuovo Tedesco greeting cards. We also had one time a luthier, Donatella Salvato, that came to share her artistry in building guitars. So that was very unique, and it was a special event. And we had Michael McMean presenting her own publisher one time. And we had João Luiz offering some insights on Brazilian music for the guitar. We had Francisco Bernier offering some explanations about his recording label, and Castellani and Andriaccio doing a duo, offering some insights about guitar technique and how to practice the guitar to become an expert player. Also, Gianmarco Ciampa offered a presentation about Villa-Lobos compositions. So our participants also learn about how you can complete your background. Besides being a player, you can also be an expert on different topics, so they can get informations about different topics. Another important element of our event is the fact that we offer to the participants the possibility to join ensembles. And now I want to play a video where we can hear few of the ensemble, very, very short clips that we had through these 11 years. Few examples of the ensembles that we were able to put together just in the week, in 6 days, and they have been performing mostly for the final concert and in other venues. So this is, for example, the Auditorium di Diocleziano, which is a Roman auditorium, and all the cisterns that have water was passing through in the past. It's a really magic and beautiful place. And this is one of the venues. The other one where we used to perform is Parco delle Arti Musicali Torri Montanare, which is a square with a tower, with medieval towers, also outdoor space. And another, during the years, we grew. And the most important thing is that we received invitations from our other organizations to join them, and they have been offering us other spaces. For example, Frisa, which is a little fraction of Lanciano, has the location of a very nice associazione that has a modern building in the countryside, a building that is made of wood and glass, so it's very beautiful. And we played a concert there in the past year, and this year we are going to do it again. And the last thing I want to talk to you about, and then I leave the word to Michael and Laura, is that we offer fellowships for our partnership with Manes Guitar Seminar. So our participants, the best participants every year are awarded, two of them are awarded a fellowship that allows them to come to New York and to attend New York Guitar Seminar at Mannes, which is an incredible opportunity for them to meet other people and to play in a very different stage in New York. So I would like now to continue the presentation and to leave the word to Laura.
I think our next slides are going to be about our outreach to Sale, which is a very small town in the mountains in the national park in Abruzzo. And it was the home of people who made strings mostly from, you know, animal guts for hundreds of years. It was a major string making town. And I think Abruzzo in general is a place where a lot of string making took place. There still is a manufacturer of gut strings that are made by hand who works in Sale, and we partner with him and present a whole day of activities in Sale, starting at this Museum of the String Makers. And we visit his factory, which is pretty interesting if you play the guitar. A lot of the people who emigrated from Sale went on to found very big companies in the United States. And so, like, for example, the Daddario family is from Sale. And the other family, Mari, which is Labella Strings, is from Abruzzo, from Sale and some from Lanciano. And some from Frentana. So I think also Savarez Strings has a connection in the past. One of the families that is now part of Savarez is also from this region. So those people who emigrated from Sale still manufacture strings, not necessarily out of gut, but they had great success moving to the United States. Everybody buys those strings. So I think it's very interesting that you can go back to Italy and find the place where they all started and the way that they made the strings and the lifestyle. So it's also incredibly beautiful. Sale is incredibly beautiful, and there's a lot to do there. We usually have a great dinner.
Do you want to show the video telling about the string making, and then you can explain?
Okay. So we have a little video about the cordai who make the strings. It's in Italian.
In queste case di orcate un tempo hanno
In queste case diroccate un tempo hanno vissuto e lavorato generazioni di artigiani che hanno fatto scuola in Italia e nel mondo. I cordari. Esperti fabbricatori di corde armoniche ricavate dal budello animale. È difficile datare con esattezza gli inizi della tradizione cordara a Salle. In paese si narra una leggenda molto cruenta, risalente al 1300 e legata alla figura del beato Roberto di Salle, patrono del borgo e discepolo di Pietro del Morrone, futuro Papa Celestino V. Si tramanda che un giorno alcuni briganti catturarono il frate mentre faceva penitenza. Alcuni sallesi lo avrebbero trovato moribondo, mentre con un ultimo sforzo cantava inni sacri al suono delle proprie budella essiccate. La storia però ci riporta al Tractatus de Musica, scritto nel 400 da Paulus Paulirinus, dove si citano strumenti che montano corde di budello. La materia prima per la realizzazione delle corde era il budello ovino, diffusissimo in un'economia pastorale, adatto per sottigliezza e resistenza. Oggi invece si usa quello bovino. Con la selezione, oggi come allora, si scelgono i budelli migliori, da destinare ai cantini dei violini, le corde che sopportano le maggiori tensioni. Gli altri si utilizzavano per i contrabbassi.
Tours of the factory, and he is showing us the pieces of intestine that they select. And the selection process is very important to get the best pieces for the type of string that might be made. There are different properties of the intestines that work better on different kinds of string. So it's going to be, is it going to be a string under a lot of tension that's really thin, or will it be for like a string base or something? And this is all the rooms where they process the strings. Once they twist them, they have to, over a period of time, tighten and tighten and tighten, and then dry them, and eventually grind them down. So when they're done, oh, this is food. I hope that's food, actually.
Yeah.
Oh, this is our lunch. So we usually have a lunch in the school. But when the strings are done, they feel like nylon. They sound like nylon strings for a little while. So this, every year we have been hosted by the town for a homemade lunch. And then people can walk around and enjoy the countryside, go to the bar, have some cafe or some beer. There's a lot of spring water. It's really refreshing, because often it's hot. And this is the view. There's Matt. And this is the Museum of Strings. We're sitting by one of the wells. This is the road. It's pretty far, it's pretty remote. I would say the village is pretty remote. And there's all our guitars. Oh, well. One of our participants with eating too much. After eating too much. La Bella. There's the museum again with its whole thing. And this is inside, and one of our hostesses. And inside the museum, there's a display of machinery from past Gutstream manufacturing. The entire town and all the different families all made strings there. That was what they all did. And they would take their strings to Naples on foot, they would carry their strings to Naples to ship out to the rest of the world. And this is a Bourbon castle. Well, it's actually a really old castle. I think it dates back to like the Middle Ages, but it was most recently owned by a Bourbon aristocrat, and it's now a restaurant. So we often have had a meal there after our day of watching strings being made, and something we've played out on the patio for the townsfolk. And some didarios actually come. And that's one of our grand meals at that place. So it's very beautiful. There's our concert stage. Oh yes, that's the mayor. Oh, one of the, I mean, I don't think he's mayor now, but he was then. And the courtyard where we set up chairs. The view, one of the many views. And that's Sally.
Okay. And now we're going to learn about one of our other outreach programs. We really love Lanciano, but we also really love going to these other communities nearby and giving the participants the opportunity to perform solos and ensembles along with the faculty. And by going to these other places, we get new audiences, new performing experiences. And this one now we're going to tell you about is Borrello, also in the mountains. This is a little bit southwest of Lanciano. There's a big lake reservoir nearby there. And we'll hear the mayor, another former mayor, because we've been doing this for so long. This is Giovanni D'Annunzio, and he's going to tell us a little bit about Borrello.
Buongiorno agli amici dell'International Guitar Seminar di Lanciano. Gli ultimi due anni siete stati ospiti del nostro comune, avete tenuto i vostri concerti nella distilleria, siamo andati a visitare le cascate le più alte d'Italia che si trovano nel nostro comune. Gli allievi e i docenti sono rimasti molto contenti. Speriamo proprio che il prossimo anno si possa fare qualcosa di ancora migliore, magari ospitandovi più giorni e facendovi visitare tutto quello che il nostro territorio offre, ed è un territorio molto bello perché oltre alla nostra riserva, qui vicino c'è la riserva regionale dell'Abete Bianco a Rosello, c'è il Parco Nazionale della Maiella, ci sono molte attrazioni che possono essere visitate dagli allievi. Ecco, qui siamo a Borrello, il paese che ha ospitato per due anni di seguito una giornata dedicata all'International Guitar Seminar di Lanciano. E questa veduta panoramica è presa dal parcheggio di accesso alle riserve Cascate del Verde. Sullo sfondo si dovrebbe vedere la Maiella, ma è coperta dalle nuvole, e di fronte ci sono le montagne del Parco Nazionale della Maiella. Un saluto da Borrello, in provincia di Chieti, a tutti gli amici del International Guitar Seminar di Lanciano.
Grazie, Sindaco. And so, just to tell you a little bit more about our activities in Borrello, with beautiful piano accompaniment. We have been pleased to receive funding from the sponsors of the Lanciano International Guitar Seminar, especially Daddario, Augustine, La Bella, and Savarez, to do work with students in these communities. So we're always doing presentations for the young people in the towns, but also doing classes with them, with hands-on programs where we help guide their guitar training. We also take the participants out to this cascade, the highest waterfall in the region, as the mayor was telling us. And it's a beautiful hike through here. And of course, we always end up with a lot of food during our time in Borrello also. This is the distillery that Isabella was mentioning. And we sometimes do the concerts here. This past year, our concert was outdoors in the amphitheater in front of the medieval church from the 11th century, I believe. And when we're working with the students there, they tend to mostly be young women who have the most interest in the guitar in this community. And I'd say they're junior high to high school age. And we've been coming back now a number of years, and we see they're playing mature as they grow. And I think probably by this year when we go back, there's going to be a bunch of them who have already run off to college. So we're going to have to start with a new crop. When we do the concerts here, it's usually toward the end of the week. So we've already gotten a number of ensemble pieces together with the participants and the faculty. And you can see some of these performances here. This is in the town square that we're seeing now. And this is the audience. It's always a very big crowd. On the days that we come, there isn't quite so much going on in Borrello, so everybody comes out for the shows. So we look forward to returning here. We're working with the new mayor to create even more programs. Oh, here's the food. We knew we would get to food eventually. And you could see that t-shirt from one of the sponsors of the New York Guitar Seminar, Bomb Cases. We always send them a lot of photos from here because a lot of people have those guitar cases. And here we are heading back home. This is just a real quick review of some team shots over the years, holding the banners of our sponsors so that they can see how grateful the participants and we are. So hard to believe 10 years has flown past, and we're very much looking forward to number 11 and no more pandemics to get on our way this time. And now it's time for some more music. So who do we have first? Matt Kaplan is going to play for us, and he will announce what he's going to do. And do you want me to move the music stand out of the way? Okay.
I'm really excited to be part of this awesome event, and thank you to our Zoom audience as well. My name is Matt Kaplan, and I went to Lanciano. I was very lucky to have received a fellowship in 2018 at the 6th annual Lanciano Guitar Festival. And I had a really great time. That was a really special year where we had the Castellani-Andreaccio duo, Michael Lahr, Isabella, and I remember all of these great events these sighs bring back some good memories of the waterfall and all of the good food that I miss very much. So it's a really great event that I feel very fortunate to have been a part of it. And happy to share some music with you all today. Today I'm gonna play a piece called The Petite Suite by James Natali. And it's in three movements. This is gonna be the Pastoral, the Toada, and I'll end with Frevo. Thank you very much.
is Avinor Metun. I participated in the seminar last year, and it was great. As you maybe saw in the pictures, I played the electric guitar, and so it was a beautiful experience for me to meet classical guitar players, see how they approach the instrument very differently, and people from all over the world, and I've never been to Italy, so it's awesome. I would play a tune of mine named A Theme for Better Days to Come.
Thank you so much, Avinon. Thank you very much, Matt, for your music. We have two more performances before we go to our aperitivo. Everybody in Zoom land, you're responsible for your own Prosecco. Drink and sit responsibly. We promise to do as well here. As you know, any event that gets put on successfully is the work of many hands. And we'd like to thank our outstanding tech team that's helping bring all of this to you today. And that's Christina and Alfio in the back. Thank you both so much. Our next guitarist has come all the way to us from Baltimore, part of the world. And we met last summer in Lanciano, and you'll learn all about the music. This is Hatim Wadani.
Hi everyone, my name is Hatim, and as you heard from Michael, I was a participant in last year's edition of the Lanciano International Guitar Seminar. Definitely by far the best experience I had throughout my guitar career. I think it was the first time for me playing, you know, in ensemble music, and then also the first time for me performing in front of people four times in 1 week. Daily masterclass classes, you know, definitely was a great experience of meeting new people. I think I definitely, I highly recommend it for everyone to join, for sure, if possible. And for today, I'm gonna play the El Decameron by Brauer, which is the third movement. It's part of three movements, and I'm gonna be playing the third one. El Decameron Negro by Brauer. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Hatim, who showed up, picked up the guitar, and played beautifully. Thank you very much. So thank you all again for coming today, whether in person or online, or watching the recorded presentation. We're going to leave you today with Katy Mayorga and Isabella Abonizio going to play a new duet that was written for them for Lanciano International Guitar Seminar. And they'll tell you all about it. And we'll get to watch a video with the composer.
So Il Borgo was composed for the Artemis guitar duo, Isabella Bonizio and Katy Mayorga. And I think they did a fantastic job. I'm very grateful to them for taking the time to practice the piece and then record it. It was composed to celebrate the 10th year anniversary of the Lanciano Guitar Seminar, which is an event that Isabella hosts every year in Italy, in Abruzzo. And the title itself, Il Borgo, refers to a hamlet, a small village, one of those that you can find in Italy everywhere. The piece explores the energetic shifts throughout the day, throughout a day, and is a suite in three movements. There is a rhythmical cell, which is ta-tam. And it is meant to ask some questions, at least in my mind, obviously. And this rhythmical cell is a shapeshifter. It changes, it transforms. And so the invitation to the audience, to the listener, is to try to find it and see how it got transformed in the second and then the third movement. Yeah, that's all. How was it?
It was great, great experience, and it's a wonderful piece. I loved it since the very beginning, and it's always nice to play a piece that nobody played before. So we are grateful to Moira for writing it, and we enjoyed again the process and the variety of the three movements very much.
Yes, thank you very much for writing it.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. We're going to play the piece that Moira Lupianco just introduced. thank you very much again to our in-person audience and our Zoom audience. We are about the end of our presentation. We would like to thank once again Collina Italiana and Comites for helping us with realizing this event. It's a very special event. And we would like to thank all our sponsors that helped us to bring the event until the 11th edition. And these are the Dario Foundation and the Savarez La Bella and Augustin Foundation, New York Ita Seminar Madness, Dal Maestro, and also the Frisa Town Hall and the Associazione Il Borgo from Borrello, Mozart and Comites again, and Collina Italiana, Toro String, and of course our host, Estate Musicale Frentana and Associazione Musica, Amici della Musica Fedele Fenaroli. Thank you everybody again, and I hope you will follow us. You can find us on the social media with Lanciano at Lanciano Guitar on Facebook and Instagram and on YouTube. And we hope you help us spreading the word about our event and helping us to grow even more than what we did so far. We would like to become even bigger. And so again, I would like to call Michael and Laura on stage with me for our last hello. Goodbye.
And to the ciao.
Okay. Hello, the performers. You guys can come. Michael, Avi, and Kathy for maybe a last picture.
Okay. Nice.
Thank you again. Thank you everybody from Zoom. Thank you so much for joining us.